The word cancer is a very emotive one, naturally. Throat cancer encompasses a wide variety of diagnoses and is probably better referred to as head and neck cancer. Now, if you imagine the head and neck to involve two conduits or passages, one that allows food to enter the body and the other that allows for breathing and production of voice, then you can then imagine a cancer can occur at any point in either of those two conduits. For example, in the mouth, in the gullet, or in the voice box. Now there are other structures in the neck as well, lymph nodes, the thyroid gland, and salivary glands. So cancer can occur in any of these parts. There are over 11,000 new cases of head and neck cancer diagnosed in the UK every year. The vast majority of them occur in the larynx or the voice box. They tend to be more common in men, so almost twice as common in men, and also tend to occur mainly in those over the age of 65. Now, unfortunately, over the last few years, the incidence of head and neck cancer has been increasing. But that's partly because we're picking up cancers in a much earlier stage. It's predicted that the incidence may fall, particularly for voice box cancers. And that is partly due to some of the victories we have in our campaign and fight against smoking. So the biggest risk factor for head and neck cancer by far is smoking tobacco. Alcohol consumption also increases your risk of developing throat cancer, but not as much. Interestingly, those who smoke and drink develop a multiplier effect and they are at higher risk. We're also learning about other risk factors, for example, HPV infection. That's the human papillomavirus. It's thought that over 50% of tonsil cancers are related to HPV infections. Because the term throat cancer encompasses a number of different diagnoses, there are also a number of different symptoms to be aware of. The important ones are, firstly, a hoarse or husky voice that has persisted for perhaps more than 3 or 4 weeks. Second, dysphagia or difficulty in swallowing, particularly if this is getting worse over a period of time. Third, an unexplained neck lump. And again, if this has lasted for more than 2 or 3 weeks and is not connected to an obvious infection or sore throat, then that's something to be concerned about. There are others, but these are the important ones to remember. So firstly, be aware of the symptoms, the red flag symptoms that can occur in head and neck cancer. And if you're worried, seek attention. Particularly if you're in the high risk group, and by that what I mean is if you're perhaps over 40, are a smoker and you drink. And if you are worried, insist on seeing a specialist, someone with the expertise and access to diagnostics who is able to diagnose the condition promptly. When you see a specialist, he or she will take a detailed history encompassing all the relevant risk factors and then perform a thorough examination. Now, during this examination, it's important to examine all the different subsites of the head and neck to ensure that a cancer isn't missed in any of these areas. Nowadays, we are able to use a flexible nasendoscope which allows us to examine the conduits I spoke about earlier, so examining the gullet, the voice box, and the back of the throat. It's a painless procedure done in outpatients, and it's really an excellent tool that gives us a really excellent view of all these areas that were hitherto very difficult to examine. Once an examination is completed, your specialist may then request some scans and perhaps even a biopsy. My take-home messages about head and neck cancer are as follows. The single most effective thing you can do to avoid developing head and neck cancer is to stop smoking tobacco. Remember the red flag symptoms. My top three are persistent hoarseness, 2, dysphagia or difficulty in swallowing that isn't getting better or getting worse, and 3, an unexplained neck lump. If you have any of these symptoms, my final tip is to seek attention from an expert, someone who has access to modern diagnostic technology and who works as part of a multidisciplinary team.